I also think that's going to be okay. I think humans have got this false belief that work equals meaning, which is not true. We just think it does.
Yeah.
And I think two things will happen. AI, whether it's over 10 years or 100 years, I can't accurately tell you which, but it will happen. That it can do most jobs better than humans. And so that leaves us with two alternatives. One, get a job that a robot can't do. And what I like about that alternative is that, with very few exceptions, most of the things that robots can do better than humans, humans don't really want to do anyway. What humans love doing is kind of freewheeling, thinking creatively. I read a quote the other day that said humans, the best thing humans are or can do is be lazy. And by lazy, it didn't necessarily mean lying on the couch, but just dreaming. Bookkeeping can be fulfilling, but it's not necessarily exciting. You know, when you get to try balance the balance, it is fulfilling. The process of getting there, I think if most people were given the choice to sit on the beach or process a general ledger, they're going to go with the beach. And I think we will hopefully get to the point as a humanity where we become very okay with that. You know, if some people want to sit around and play Xbox all day, I think that's okay. I don't think we should judge them, provided society as a whole isn't losing. And I think by then we'll be at the point where the gains from AI will be so immense, that we won't be bothered by so-and-so is or isn't working. On the flip side, there will be this period between the explosion of AI and the job destruction and the implementation of some sort of basic income or subsidy. That lag will be because of greed. And that lag will be a very awful period. When the basic income of whatever form it takes comes in, because it will have to. And the reason why I say it will have to is because logic takes me there.
Yeah.
Poor is a relative concept, not an absolute concept. You can't have poor without rich.
Yeah.
So if you don't have a basic income grant, the rich get richer and the poor get poorer. What's the logical conclusion to that? 0.1% of the people with all the money and 99.9% with no money. Now, I know this. I'm a fairly rule-abiding human, and I think I'm a kind and ethical one. But if you're walking through the desert with some water and my children were thirsty, I would ask you really nicely to share. But if I was faced with taking it from you or having my children die, I'm taking your water. I'm sorry, but it's going to happen. And if you put up a fight, you know, one of us is going down because my kids are there. And I think that goes for every single human. And so if 0.1% of the people have all the money, how do they stop the 99.9% from taking it? You can only build a wall so high.
Yeah.
And it will come to the point where the richest of the rich will have no choice, just their own survival, to share with the poor. And the best way to do that is with a basic income grant that just says, you know, let's raise the floor.
Yeah.
Personally, I don't like seeing poor people. And selfishly, it just makes me feel terrible. Look, you can't though. And so I would rather pay money to eliminate poverty and be slightly less rich myself.
Yeah.
And I think, again, that goes for most people. And so I don't think a basic income grant is a choice. It will become a necessity by the very people who right now think it's a bad idea because they have all the money. I look at it this way. So once you've got your basic needs met, so you can house yourself, you can clothe yourself, you can feed yourself, your family, etc., etc., then you have a lot of choice. Now, if we had a captain of the world, which has to happen at some point, and also, again, logical conclusion, I do believe that we will have some sort of global existential crisis, whether it's our planet is dying or dead and we have to leave it, or an alien invasion, which is certainly not impossible. Maybe, I think it's highly unlikely in our time frame, but in an infinite time frame, it's highly unlikely we're the only ones on the planet. Therefore, at some point, we're going to see another life force. And at that point, I think we will quickly realize that, you know, US versus North Korea is irrelevant when it comes to Earth versus universal invader. And so we will rally together and you know, become mates as a society. Yes. Oh, so if you had this captain of the world, now everyone's got their basic needs taken care of, and he said, look guys, we need this, the Earth's going to die, we need to get to Mars because Elon Musk failed or whatever reason, who wants to help? I'll put my hand up. Because it sounds fun and exciting, and I don't need to go and work as a whatever to feed my family. That's done. I get bored very quickly. I mean, I've played every computer game I can think of, and I don't desire to go back.
Yeah.
Not constantly, anyway. Not 8 hours a day. And at the same time, I think that, you know, if the captain of the world said, you know, guys, we need to cure cancer, put your hand up. 10 million people are putting their hands up. Most doctors are not doctors for the paycheck. You know, they're doctors because they're compassionate, they've got the intelligence, and they want to help people. And if they got a paycheck through some other means, I don't think that's going to change.
Yeah.
And so I think we will do the stuff that matters and let the robots do the rest.